Hi, welcome to our new Python series. Objective of today's session is to deliver you good fundamental knowledge of Python. This session we shall focus on Python features like general purpose, interpreted, multi-paradigm, high level language, simple structure, cross-platform, open source, dynamic types, garbage collection and extensible. Before we begin with the session, who invented Python? It was created by Guido van Rossum in late 1990s. The language is named after a BBC comedy show, Monty Python's Flying Circus. At the time, it has limited popularity. Suddenly, in 2004, organizations like NASA and huge companies such as Google, Dropbox, YouTube, etc. got to know the importance of this language and started using it. So, because of this corporate backing and buzzwords like machine learning, data science, artificial intelligence, Python became more popular. Let's begin with features of Python. It is general purpose because it doesn't have just one purpose, like C has console application or SQL has database. However, Python can be used for GUI programs, web program, machine learning, desktop applications and many more. Next feature. It is interpreted. However, before interpretation, it gets compiled. Please note here, compiler do not always convert source code to machine code. It happens only with the C program. Like Java, Python compilers converts source code to bytecode. Here, compilation involves three steps: lexing, parsing, generating. What is lexing? Lexing is the process of splitting characters to tokens. These tokens are then stored in memory as output. The software that does this is a lexer. For example, if this is a source code. Here, lexer reads the entire code and converts this code to tokens which looks like this. Tokens contain numbers, identifiers, operators and keywords. You see, there are square brackets and within them you can see nested square brackets. In outermost square bracket, we have two statements, while and return. While comprises two sets of square bracket, first condition, second block statement. Condition has left side variable, operator and then right side constant value 0. Block statement has branching statement if and else. If comprises two sets of square bracket, first condition, second block statement. Condition has left side variable, operator, right side variable. Second square bracket is for block statement. That is assignment statement here. So in this square bracket, we have assignment variable equal to operator and square bracket for formula. Formula has left side variable, operator minus and right side variable. Now, else part that has no condition but the block statement, which again is assignment statement. So here we have assignment variable equal to operator and the square bracket for formula. Other than while, we have return statement that returns variable A. Parsing is the next process. Parser organizes tokens to AST or abstract syntax tree. Here it takes two inputs. First one is grammar software and second tokens created by lexer. With the help of grammar, it validates each token and then arranges them in syntax tree. For example, if these are the tokens, the parser arranges them in AST which looks like this. Now, in the main node of statements, you can see here two child nodes, while and return. As per grammar software, while has condition and body. So first is condition as not equal to operator with two comparison values. Left is variable and right is constant value 0. Then with the body, we have branching statements. If and else. Here only if part has condition, So as per grammar, we have if condition, if body and else body. Likewise, we can see here that tokens are organized in syntax tree structure. Thus, AST gets organized in stages as well as it also provides extra information. Here you see, A has additional information as it is a variable and 0 with information as constant. Generating is the next process. Here, generator converts AST to code objects, that is bytecode. Now, interpreter takes over bytecode and executes it line by line. Python interpreter is a software-based virtual machine. This can be written in any language. First is C Python, which is written in C. It comes default with the Python installation. Here, it compiles source code to bytecode and then interprets it. Next one is Jython. Jython compiles Python code to Java bytecode and then JVM executes it. Next is IronPython. It uses both Python code and .NET libraries and also exports Python code to other languages. Some other implementations are PyPy, PythonNet and many more. Still, Python is known as interpreted language because the way programmer interacts with it. Here, if Python program has some error, then it shows error at that line of code and stops execution. Next, Python is multi-paradigm. This means here we can write code using variety of approaches such as POP, OOP, etc. Though Python supports procedure-oriented program, everything here is an object and there are no primitive types. Language has no public, private or protected keyword and so cannot be considered as fully object-oriented programming as well. However, it has classes, objects and likewise features of OOP. Next, Python is high-level language. As we know, low-level languages are near to machine code, like C or assembly language. Python is away from machine code. Some other reasons to call it as high-level language are its codes are concise, syntax are flexible and ease of writing code. Next, it has few keywords and simple structure. C++ and Java programmers found it very similar to these languages with few differences. In C++ or Java, we use curly braces for control structures, classes or functions. Python uses indentation instead. Here, we can solve complex problems in less time with fewer lines of code. To write a small code of Hello World, Python just writes a command for it. It doesn't need any additional main method, class, nothing. C++, Java or other languages use them. Next feature is, it is cross-platform language. This means Python code that we run on Macintosh computer will run easily on Linux or any other platform. Even on Windows, it will run fine. However, the only prerequisite here is on Windows, Python interpreter must be pre-installed. For other operating system, it comes pre-installed. Next, Python is open source. It is free available on python.org website. From here, we can easily download and install it. Next, it supports dynamic data types and dynamic type checking. Here, we don't need to declare variable as we do in other languages. For example, in Java we say int x equal to 10. Python takes care of its data type. We have to simply say here x equal 10. Here, Python understands that 10 is a number, so x automatically becomes a number type. In program, we can even change these values with other types. For example, we can say here x equal in double quotes Mamta. Now x becomes string type. Next feature is garbage collection. This will monitor and release memory automatically for objects. In languages like C++, programmers are responsible for allocation and deallocation of memory objects. If they fail to deallocate memory, then it produces out of memory error. Garbage collection is an assistant process for languages like Java or Python. So these languages are known as robust languages. Different languages use different algorithm for garbage collection. Python uses reference counting algorithm. Next, it is extensible. This means other languages like C or C++ can be used to compile the code and can be easily integrated with these languages. Here we end the session. Next video we shall do code fundamentals of Python. Kindly do share, like and subscribe. Thank you.